गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द नेशनल ह्यूमन राइट्स कमीशन विच वर्क्स एज द प्रोटेक्टर ऑफ फंडामेंटल राइट्स एंड ह्यूमन राइट्स. इन दिस सीरीज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द फ्यू गाइडलाइंस विच वर गिवन बाय आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन मेकर्स फॉर द गवर्नमेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ पॉलिसी मेकिंग. They are directive principles of state policy. The makers of our constitution knew that independent India was going to face many challenges. Foremost among these was the challenge to bring about equality and well-being of all citizens. They also thought that certain policy direction was required for handling these problems. At the same time, the constitution makers did not want future governments to be bound by certain policy decisions. In a simple way, we can say these two points were highlighted by our constitution maker. Firstly, they wanted to add some guidelines for the government for their consideration. And also they wanted these type of guidelines should not be bound for the government according to changing scenario. So now we can discuss the definition or the meaning of directive principles of state policy. As you are thinking about the name, these are the guidelines, directive for directions, principles means rules and regulation of state policy. So the accurate definition of directive principles of state policy, the directive principles of state policy of India are the guidelines or 15 principles given to the federal institutes governing the state of India to be kept in citation while framing laws and policies. Or we can say these are guidelines, these are the suggestions for the government while government is framing laws and policies. Or we can say it aims to create, what is the aim of these principles? It aims to create social and economic conditions under which the citizen can lead a good life. Means the motto of the constitution makers was for the welfare of citizens of India. They also aim to establish a social and economic democracy through a welfare state. Students, here I want to explain the meaning of welfare state. Welfare state means a state which is doing good works for the citizens. In earlier times, people thought the role of the state is limited to protection of the life of the citizens. But nowadays, the work or field of state or country has increased. So we can say a state must be provide good life conditions for their citizens. So if a state is providing, that state is a welfare state. As we have discussed, the constitution makers added some principles for government to make the policies. Therefore, some guidelines were incorporated in the constitution, but they were not made legally enforceable. As we discussed the two points, constitution makers thought these guidelines should not be bound for government. So, this means that if a government did not implement a particular guideline, we cannot go to the court asking the court to instruct the government to implement that policy. Or in short, we can say limitations of directive principles of state policy is it has no legal force. Means we cannot go in the court against if directive principles are not following by the government. These guidelines are non-justiciable part of the constitution that cannot be enforced by the judiciary. Those who framed our constitution thought that the moral force behind these guidelines means constitution maker followed morally certain principles and they were expecting future governments should consider these guidelines. Some thinkers observe the directive principles of state policy are conservative in nature, means the concept of directive principle is too old and that is not relevant in present scenario. It may produce constitutional conflict between center and state. Sometime, as you know, India is following federal form of government, means division of power between center and state. So sometime these directive principles create conflict between the state and center. So besides, our constitution makers expected that the people would also hold the governments responsible for implementing these directives. So a separate list of policy guidelines is included in the constitution. The list of these guidelines is called the directive principles of state policy. Now, constitution makers mentioned three main features in the directive principles. First, the goals and objectives that we as a society should adopt. Means in this category, few features have given which are followed to create or make a good society. Second, certain rights that individuals should enjoy apart from the fundamental rights. Means individuals should follow certain rules and regulation, and those rules and regulation will create the enjoyment for others also. And third one is certain policies that the government should adopt. Government, while framing the laws or making the laws or policies, government should keep in the mind that suggestions. You may get some idea of the vision of makers of our constitution by looking at some of the directive principles shown on the screen. Now you can understand the concept of directive principles of state policy. And I also mention some rules which are made under the guidelines of these principles, and that such a type of rules are very much famous in our society, and also the citizens of India like them. The government from time to time tried to give effect to some directive principles of state policy. They passed several Jamidari abolition bills. This was under the guidelines of directive principles. Nationalized banks, enacted numerous factories laws, fixed minimum wages, cottage and small industries were promoted, and provisions for reservation for the upliftment of the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes were made. Such efforts to give effect to the directive principles include in the right of education, formation of Panchayati Raj institutions all over the country, partially right to work under employment guarantee program and the midday meal scheme, etc. I hope the topic is clear to you, and also you get the meaning of directive principles, which are too much important for our government while framing policies. Thank you and have a nice day.